Nearly 90% of the world's sickle cell population lives in three countries: Nigeria, India, and the Democratic Republic of Congo. In Congo, the disease affects up to 2% of the population, and Nigeria alone has been estimated to have at least 150,000 newborns born into the sickle cell disease annually. Today on Health Matters, your TV health program, we'll be talking about genotype incompatibility. It is especially worrisome that in Nigeria, we have a lot of sickle cell carriers, and despite the awareness, the education, it is still happening. People are still giving birth to children with sickle cell disease. Today, my name is Patricia Omonori. Today on the program, we have a nursing officer in the house at Fertility and Gynecology Center, Miss Patricia Ndukwe, to shed more light on what genotype incompatibility is. You're welcome to the program. Today we are going to be talking about genotype incompatibility. For someone like me, I just understand it to be that maybe AA cannot marry SS, but I know that there's still so much more about it. So can you tell us what genotype incompatibility really is?
Okay. Well, you see, this topic, like you said, there has been continuous awareness and sensitization, but I think it's not enough because, like you said, annually we have 150,000 children born with sickle cell disease, and that's very high. The prevalence rate is high. So, well, maybe a lot of people already know, but we'll shed more light at the course of this program. So we'll start by explaining what genotype is. Genotype is simply defined as the genetic composition that makes up an individual inherited from both parents. So before you can say I am AA or I am AS, it has to be composed from both of your parents that yes, I am AS. So if you can't just come out and say I am AS or I am SS when both genotype are not from your parents. So it has to be from an individual, from a parent, to make up your genetic composition.
Okay, so what you mean to say, Patricia, is that it can never happen for you to have another genotype aside from what your parent has?
From an individual, because it might not be your biological parent,
okay,
but what makes up an individual, whatever genotype you have, it's from an individual.
Okay.
So it might not be your biological parent.
Really?
Of course.
Okay, so let's talk about maybe in the case of surrogacy.
Yes.
Is it possible that the newborn can adopt the genotype of the birth mother?
Well, when surrogacy comes, it's just a carrier. So it has nothing to do with the genetic composition of the person who is carrying. It has to do with the gene. DNA is what is responsible for genotype. So it has to be from the parent of that individual.
Okay.
So it's what is responsible for genotype is DNA. If you are not, I'm not carrying your DNA, I'm not yours.
Oh, so yeah. If the person has a genotype that is not of the father or of the mother, definitely that child is not theirs.
Yes.
Okay, now I understand. So now let's talk about genotype incompatibility. What exactly is this genotype incompatibility? How can we be incompatible genetically?
Okay, just like we have when there is a guy and a girl in love,
okay,
and you are checking, am I compatible with this person health-wise, spiritual-wise? Same thing with, you know, in medicine, you have to check if you are compatible with this person, and that's what brought about genotype incompatibility. So if both of you are not compatible, it means both of you cannot get married. So we have different types of genotypes. So if I am AS, I am at risk of getting married to someone who also have same genotype with me, AS, because at the end of the day, we may have a sickle cell child.
Okay, and that is so bad?
It is deadly.
Oh, it is deadly. And I think that's where the sickle cell disease comes in. So for now, if you have AS and AS, you cannot get married.
No.
Are there ways around this thing?
Well, there is, but it's quite expensive.
Okay, and what kind of procedure?
I eventually say I want to get married to someone who has AS, just as I'm AS now, that option can be, we just want to get married without conception.
Okay.
Because it is when conception comes into place that the sickle cell disease arises.
Okay.
But if we decide to say we just want to get married, enjoy ourselves without a child, then that is an option.
Okay.
But if we want to have a child and we do not want a sickle cell child, that means we want to go through IVF, where they will have to do pre-embryo selection before implantation of that baby. But that's way too expensive.
Okay, that's way too expensive. I want to take you back now, Patricia. We are talking about the types of genotype.
Yes.
But you only talked about AS. Are there other types that maybe are not known to a layman like me?
Typically, we have five distinct types of genotype. We have the AA, that's the king of kings.
Yes.
We have the AA, we have the AS, we have the AC, it's quite rare.
Okay.
And then we have the SC and SS. So the SC and SS are the irregular, and they are commonly the ones that cause sickle cell disease.
The SC and the SS.
SS.
So can you break down the other one? You said something like AC, so those ones are not carriers.
AC is carrier. They are sickle cell trait carrier.
Okay, so what you mean
but
to say
rare.
Is, for example, someone that has AC genotype cannot also marry someone that has AS genotype.
Yes. You will have SC. 25 chances of pregnancy could be SC.
25%. So it's not like 100%. You can still...
Even the successive pregnancy.
Okay.
If I have one with SS and I get pregnant again, I cannot tell if that pregnancy will also be SS or normal or A. So it's chances, it's from probability. It's just like playing balls.
You're playing dice with
yes.
someone's life. Well, I also read in my research that there are ways to know if there's a fetus is carrying this disease or is a carrier.
Yeah.
So what kind? How do we know? Can you explain that?
Well, it's been done during pre-antenatal section.
Okay.
When you go for and then it's chromosomal genotype testing.
Okay.
It's been done here in Nigeria as well. I really don't know how expensive it is, but
okay.
But even at that, when it is done and the answer is that the child is SS or SC, well, there are so many psychological and emotional, so many people do not actually like to go
to
into
test, to check.
Yes.
Okay, all right. But even this procedure now, can you tell us, is it risky, is it fatal to the fetus, the checking for whether the baby is a carrier or not?
Well, it just has to do with selecting the couple, the man and the woman. It
yeah,
has
okay.
nothing to do with the
child.
Child,
okay.
So when you select, after the fertilization has happened,
mm-hmm.
and you want to transfer, during the fertilization process, so the genotype selection is being done. Actually, that is being handled by the embryologist.
Okay, so it has to be something like maybe IVF.
Yes.
Okay, cannot be natural conception.
It cannot be done with natural conception.
Oh, okay, all right. Okay, that's a very enlightening one, and I hope you've learned something in the house. Let's go for a quick break, and when we come back, Patricia and Ndukwe will still shed more light on the prevention and the cure for this sickle cell disease, if there is any. Don't go away. Yeah, welcome back to Health Matters, the TV Health program. And today we have a nursing officer in the house talking to us about genotype incompatibility. We have Patricia and Ndukwe in the house. And so far we've talked about the types of genotype we have. We talked about the risk of two people that are carriers getting married or having a conception. But now there's something I know to be mother to fetal genotype incompatibility. Do you know about this and can you shed light on
it? That's not genotype, that has to do with blood group.
Okay.
That's actually a different topic entirely. That has to do with rhesus factor.
Okay.
So that's when it has nothing to do with the genotype.
So you mean that because research shows that a mother to child can have genetic incompatibility, genotype incompatibility actually, and it seems to have been the basis for schizophrenia actually, that maybe it is from their incompatibility that makes the child grow up to be someone with schizophrenia. So has there been any research on that in Ondo State at all?
None that I'm aware of.
All right, let's talk about cross-matching now. We know that there's no way that you can't get married or keep looking. So what do you think that I should know if I'm AS or AC in marrying someone or choosing a partner for conception now?
Okay, like I said earlier, the AAs are the king of genotypes.
Yes.
I mean, they are allowed and they can marry any types of other genotypes.
Okay.
In fact, we advise them more to marry. You know, they have the advantage of reducing the population.
Okay.
With sickle cell disease, so they can actually marry SS, marry SC, AC, other types. Because when you marry, you are AA, you marry SC, you just come down with AS, AC, so
okay,
you will not have a sickle cell. You just have a carrier trait,
okay,
which is still fine. You understand? So if you are AS, please do not marry AS. Do not marry SC. Do not marry SS.
How about AC?
You cannot marry AC.
Okay.
Just AA alone. For other types of genotypes, aside AA, they are only allowed to marry someone with genotype AA.
Okay. Every other by genotype groups can only marry someone with AA.
Yes.
But AA can marry and is advised to marry someone, because really the statistics is worrisome. 150,000 newborns, not even adults or teenagers now with the disease. Okay, let's talk about prevention now, because we all know that prevention is better than cure.
Yes.
What preventive measures can be put in place to ensure that I, as someone like as AC or AS, does not get married or have a child with someone, with the same person with the same genotype?
Well, like you said earlier, continuous awareness and sensitization.
Okay.
So it's going to be from the grassroots. Like every June 16th of the year is actually termed an African child, African Day for the child.
Okay.
And one of the rights of a child, according to UNICEF, is the right to health. So if we can take it down to the grassroots from the secondary schools, where they can easily identify their left from their right, a lot of them are going into relationships, you understand? So it is necessary that we understand that, oh, you need to know your genotype, go for genotype screening test and identify your type, that, okay, I'm AS. So when you identify your type, I am not of the opinion that during your first date in your relationship, that should be a criteria or what you want to. But before ones go deep into emotions and relationship, you need to know the genotype of your partner, especially if you are of the genotype of AS, SS, SC, you understand?
Okay.
It puts you at risk for sickle cell disease, or, you know, having a child with sickle cell disease. So you want to ensure that this is one of your criteria, you know, so that you don't, you know, the adverse effects of having a sickle cell disease is very challenging, and I don't think and wish any couple wants to go through all that. So it is very important that we sensitize them as early as possible. Also, premarital testing and counseling. I mean, we want to get married. It is part of the test. I think couples should go into before even saying, yes, I do.
Okay.
So, and then you'll be counseled Of course, if I'm AS and my partner is AS, you know, and we have been dating.
We are in love.
It's at that point you want to decide either it is love or genotype.
Okay.
It's broken. It's heartbroken. But it can be solved. I mean, there are other men or women out there who could also give you what you want. But if you have a sickle cell child, it's your child, and you have the one to face the challenges. So it is very important that premarital testing and counseling, early screening of know my genotype, you should know your genotype. Ask question, ask your, or if possible, both of you go for the screening test at least to be sure that you are not putting each other at risk.
Okay, that's quite a lot of awareness on that. But now let's talk about, you said something about challenges. What challenges do you think can arise from being or having a child that has this SCD or having a sickle cell yourself?
You know, it's quite emotional to have a child with sickle cell disease. At intervals, they could have pain, crisis. You don't want to see them go through that pain. It's, you know, most of their lives, it's about pain. Because, you know, the red blood cell is sickled. So getting enough blood, transporting to every part of your organ, it's quite limited for them. So if they're in pain, it's very severe. And they don't tend to live longer, although with lifestyle changes, awareness, and, you know, sensitization now, people with sickle cell disease can actually live as long as they want, as long as they adhere to the instructions of their care provider.
Okay, so, but what's generally the lifespan?
Under 40 years.
Wow, that's really traumatic. But now let's come to that. Okay, now I chose love, and now I have a child with sickle cell, or I am a sickle cell carrier. What do you think can be done to at least help this person live a normal life, or as normal a life as possible?
You are a sickle cell carrier, you are fine. Sickle cell carrier is AS.
Oh, okay.
You understand? But if you have sickle cell disease, that is SS. Yes. So you just continue, you go to your care provider at all times. You have any complaint, you go over and over and over as much as you, just to stay healthy. But most times we encourage them to stay healthy, rehydration, like they keep taking a lot of water, which helps them to stay healthy. You know, they live like normal human beings, you understand? Not that they're, it's just that at intervals their immune system is not as high as the other types of, you know, AA especially.
Are there any maybe diet or a lifestyle that they can live or they should live different from they're normal people but different from other people maybe with AA to at least help them to elongate their lives?
Just like every other person, you want to tell us to generally you want to live a healthy lifestyle, preventive lifestyle. You want to reduce excessive alcohol consumption.
Okay.
You are a sickler. I don't expect you to be taking alcohol
at all.
Okay. What you need is fluid, water, hydration. You understand? You don't need to smoke. You don't need to do those things that will put you, your immune system is low already. Yeah, okay. You don't need to do those things that will cause more harm to you. So you want to stay. You can eat any food you want to eat. You understand? But in terms of medications, you always make sure you see your care provider because not all medications that they can take.
Not all medications that can take. But are there medical procedures that could at least help someone with the sickle cell disease?
Well, the last option is bone marrow transplant.
Yeah.
I think for now, it's being done at Lutz, but it's very expensive. Very expensive. Just like every other procedure, there are also side effects. But I mean, this is the way better solution for them. But the only challenge is for many of us or for people who actually constitute this population of sickle cell disease, they are mainly, you know, local people or people who aren't even aware of their genotype. So can they afford such money? And if they have to travel abroad to do this procedure, do they even have that money? So I think it's just a way to reduce the population that we need to talk about so that it will reduce that pain and suffering that
the child has to
go through.
And what do you think, as a nursing officer in the field, and I've seen your experience, what is your advice to the public?
Well, my advice will be that before you say I do to someone, you should first know your genotype. I mean, as an adult, it's very unfair that there are so many adults currently who still do not know the status of their genotype. So it is advised that you know your genotype first, and then before you say I do to your partner, you ensure that your partner also knows his or her genotype, and you are sure that this is the genotype of this person before you both go ahead. Just like you said earlier, ensure that the screening test for genotype is done in 3 different or different labs to verify your results for confirmation before you said yes, I do to this person.
All right, thank you very much, Miss Patricia Ndukwe, a nursing officer. I'm sure you have heard something and you've learned something. We know a little bit about genotype, and we know a little bit about genotype incompatibility, but it is important for us to know that if you choose love over genotype incompatibility, think of the trauma, the pain that your child will have to go through, and just think of other options. To prevent is actually better than cure when it comes to the sickle cell disease. So we have to be careful. We have to make sure that we do our health check. We have to check our genotype before even going further, taking our relationship further. And this is also very important to seek a first, second, and a third opinion, if you ask me, because we've seen cases where these genotype tests have come out wrong before marriage. So it is better to seek opinions and do testing different clinics just to be sure about this disease, especially if your partner has is a carrier, so to say. So today on Health Matters, we've had a wonderful time with Patricia Ndukwe. Thank you so much for coming on
the program.
Yes, and you've heard it all. Until next time on Health Matters, your TV health program, my name is Faye Sharia Omonore, and it's bye for now.